The Senate Tuesday voted against moving forward with sweeping climate change legislation known as the Green New Deal. No senators voted to move forward with the current legislation. 57 senators, including 4 Democrats, voted against it. And 43 senators simply voted present, including all 6 who have announced presidential bids. The measure was introduced by New York Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez and Massachusetts Senator Edward Markey. It seeks to reduce greenhouse gases and move the U.S. toward 100% renewable energy. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, who brought the plan up for a vote, has called it a, quote, socialist daydream. A number of Democratic lawmakers fired back at McConnell for holding the vote, calling it a sham because it was held without any hearings or expert testimony. Let's bring in Caitlin Huey Burns and Varshini Prakash. Caitlin is a CBSN political reporter, and Varshini is the co-founder and executive director of the Sunrise Movement, an advocacy group focusing on climate change. Welcome to you both. Varshini, first of all, what is your reaction to today's vote?
Sure. Overall, I think it was really positive. Look, the Green New Deal resolution was never intended to pass the Senate. It's a statement of principles. It's a vision document for charting a path towards a renewable energy, a future, and an economy that works for all people. So to that end, Mitch McConnell's ultimate goal in all of this was to try and fracture Democrats. And they actually voted with a united front, voted present, to share that this was a sham vote. That it was disingenuous and that it wasn't in good faith. So all in all, I think it shows that Mitch McConnell and the GOP elite really don't have a plan to address the climate crisis and rather are sticking to political ploys to curry favor with their oil and gas donors.
Caitlin, help us break down this vote. We saw a number of Democrats vote present. What position are Democrats in when it comes to climate change measures like this one?
Right. And most of the senators running for president in 2020 on the Democratic side also voted present. So the goal there on behalf of Democrats was to keep a united front because they didn't believe that this was actual legislation. It was just a proposal the way it was introduced. Republicans were trying to get these Democrats on record and say, well, if you're out there on the campaign trail talking about the Green New Deal, saying you support it, why not vote on it? So that's kind of the politics at play here. Democrats, however, feel very confident in voting together in one block. You did have a few defections, those from, Alabama or West Virginia. Democrats like Joe Manchin voted with Republicans. But Democrats do feel like this is an effective statement of principles, as you just alluded to, especially for a campaign that is going to see a lot of energy around the idea of climate change and asking for proposals to do that. And Democrats want to put the pressure back on Republicans to come at least forward with acknowledging the kind of a statement of values and facts.
Varshini, I'm wondering, do you think that this bill tried to do too much too soon? And would this outcome have been any different, you think, if there were hearings held on it?
Yeah, I mean, there have been a lot of people talking about it being too radical or too all-encompassing and more. But frankly, what I think is truly radical in this moment is to not do something to stop the climate crisis. We are seeing reports that are telling us that by mid-century, we're going to see 150 million climate refugees. We're hearing reports that the entire coral reefs are going to be gone, that hundreds of millions of people are going to suffer premature deaths due to pollution. So climate denialism in this moment is a completely untenable position. And frankly, I think the GOP elite looked ridiculous out on the Senate floor today, saying that solutions to the climate crisis are that people should settle down and have families and have kids. I mean, to them, it seems like they're taking it as a joke. But for people in my generation, for working people, for communities of color, this is the greatest existential threat facing human civilization as we know it.
You know, Caitlin, Republican Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell said that he believes in climate change and that humans have contributed to it. Is there a shift that we're starting to see now in the way that Republicans talk about this issue?
You know, you have seen an acknowledgement from some Republicans that they have to address this issue. And a lot of that has to do with the way the public is viewing this. Last fall, CBS had its own polling showing that 61% of Americans believed that climate change was real and that it was man-made. So you're seeing the public pressure build up, and especially as we're heading into an election cycle, I hear this over and over again from voters. But they also were trying to argue that some of the principles outlined in the Green New Deal went beyond climate change. Part of it is a federal jobs guarantee and other measures that would be highly disruptive to industries. Now, Democrats argue that that could be a good thing, but Republicans were voicing concern about that. So even those who are trying to talk about this issue aren't at all ready to support the Green New Deal. In fact, they see it as a wedge to drive not only between Democrats but among independent voters.
So, Varshini, given all of that, would you accept legislation that does not go as far as the current proposal but still addresses some of the core issues?
Yeah, I mean, I'll say there's a long way to go on that road. There's a lot of things that we need to do just in the next few years. The entire conversation has shifted in the last 4 months. We went from the Green New Deal being a completely niche policy to now becoming the number one most popular policy amongst Democratic caucus goers. We're seeing Democratic presidential candidates advocating for the Green New Deal on Fox News and campaigning on it every single day. Everything has changed about the way that we talk about the climate crisis in our national debate. So now, moving forward, what we really need to do is get Trump out of office. We need to elect pro-climate action, pro-good jobs majorities in both the House and the Senate. We need to build a robust movement of millions of people to keep up the pressure. And we need to elect more people like Representative Ocasio-Cortez and Rashida Tlaib and others whose primary allegiance is to working people and who are going to fight tooth and nail within that hall of the halls of power to pass the legislation that's gonna prioritize the needs of young people. So what we need to understand is that the Green New Deal, as it's in its current formulation, isn't a piece of legislation to pass, but what it does is actually show us all the different pieces of legislation that's going to pass over the next few years if we build a coalition of support powerful enough to help it pass through. So this includes things like the creation of tens of millions of good, high-paying jobs. It includes programs to retrofit our buildings, decreasing energy costs for consumers. It looks like investments in sustainable agriculture and renewable energy technologies as well.
I want to ask about how this issue is being framed. Democratic presidential candidate and former Colorado Governor John Hickenlooper authored an op-ed in Tuesday's Washington Post titled, "The Green New Deal Sets Us Up for Failure. We Need a Better Approach." Hickenlooper also writes, quote, "If climate change policy becomes synonymous in the U.S. psyche with higher utility bills, rising taxes, and lost jobs, we will have missed our shot and we might not get another one before it's too late." Varshini, what's your reaction to that?
Look, Governor Hickenlooper, when he was the governor of Colorado, we saw that he was largely in cahoots with oil and gas, and we know that they still have his ear. So I'm not surprised to see this op-ed whatsoever. What I think is extremely clear, however, is that the Green New Deal will be the litmus test for Democrats on the campaign trail to 2020. And if he even wants to compete in this race, he's going to have to come around and embrace some of the most exciting, visionary, and needed policy proposals that are on the table right now and that young voters and many voters in the Democratic base are fired up about.
All right. We'll continue to watch it closely. Caitlin Huey Burns and Varshini Prakash, thank you both for your time. Really appreciate it.